Well, we've been talking about health care, and another topic near and dear to Ron Paul, of course, is the Fed, and he was on a crusade to audit the Fed, but now comes his new chairman, Janet Yellen. So we continue now with former Congressman Ron Paul, and to take off your doctor hat and put on your congressman hat, you were pretty vocal about it, and your son is working. I know you don't speak for him, but he's working on basically what you were working on, audit the Fed. Why do you explain to the audience why that's such a big deal? Why do you want to audit them?
Because I think they're so important and we don't know what they do. And they claim they're transparent and they let us know. But I think if nothing else that came out of the crisis of 08 and 09 was the fact that the Fed was a big player. And if you understand the monetary policy, they created the problems, they created the malinvestment and all the debt, and they created the bubble. And therefore, the correction comes, and they're supposed to correct it by doing more of the same thing. But there was a lot of things done in secret, and we did get some information out with this emphasis on a more transparency about some of the foreign transaction. Literally, there were estimates between $10 and $15 trillion that were used to, you know, help a bank here, help a corporation here, help a government here, and that shouldn't be. The Fed is bigger than the federal government. They can deal in trillions. You know, it was less than $1 trillion the Congress used to bail out some of the corporations, but the Fed is very, very big, and they are the culprit. They are the culprit for the business cycle. And if people say, no, they're the solution, then we have a long way to go. But I think the first step in reform is transparency so that we know what they're doing. The American people are with us on this. 75%, 80% of the American people say, yeah, you should know more about the Fed and what they're doing. And I think that's a great idea.
Well, give us, I know you're a big guy on history of all of this. And so you go back to when Congress created the Federal Reserve System, and on paper, Congressman, that seems smart. Get the monetary policy out of the political world. Don't let members of Congress, you know, fool with the monetary policy. But was it a good idea? And would you want to bring monetary policy back to members of Congress to decide?
No, you don't want Congress doing the same thing the Fed does, because they would print money also. But they work in collusion. The congressmen, they spend the money, and they know darn well that the debt will be taken care of. You know, that's why we knew there would not be a default on the debt. The Fed always takes care of it. So the big question is should anybody have the power to create money out of thin air? And the big problem with the creation of the Fed is they thought was a wonderful thing, the lender of last resort. So everybody can make mistakes and gamble away, don't sweat it. The banks, if they get into trouble, they know they're going to be bailed out. So there's a moral hazard to this, and there's all this kind of insurance that encourages people to do the wrong thing. And if they prop it up and patch it together like we did for decades until this last crisis, the patching up has been more difficult. So it's structurally challenged right now, and that's why we won't get over this without some serious changes in monetary policy and spending policies, because believe me, the Congress and the Fed know exactly what they're doing. They work together. The Congress can. It was just, say, for instance, the Fed couldn't buy government debt.
Yeah.
Well, immediately interest rates would go up and the Congress would have to quit. But there's too much of a great appetite for the programs, and we've had the license to spend because we've been issuing the world currency. They still take our currency and it's strong, but it won't last forever. And we're just trying to warn people, be prepared, because the crisis is going to be a lot worse than we saw in 09, and that we ought to have a good handle on the responsibility of the Fed and how they cause so much of our problems.
I agree. I think your moral hazard point, especially, and the bubble, that they're doing the same thing that created the bubble, are doing the same thing again. So here we come up with the term ending for Ben Bernanke. Now there's even some rumors they may delay that. But Janet Yellen, give me your take on what do you expect the Fed to look like under Janet Yellen?
Well, more of the same, but only worse, because she's very vocal that she supported all the QEs. And most people, in analyzing all that she has said and done, means that if anything, she would even do it faster. So if QE3, once they admit it isn't working, she's going to give us perpetual QE4. And she may devise some system that gets the money into the hands of the consumer more readily, rather than just giving it to the bank and letting the banks get bailed out. She would believe this. So she probably, I don't know.